Hello guys, so today I'll be showing you how I edit my photos, even though I'm not really good at it. So one of my friends from Instagram requested it, and I also want to embarrass myself, so let's get into it. I'll be showing you how to turn this photo to this photo. So without further ado, let's dive in. Alright, let's go. So the first thing I'm gonna do is to crop the photos and straighten it. I'm gonna crop it to 4x5 because I think that's the maximum size Instagram allows you to put. At least I think so. And also adjusting the composition of the photos as well. And then we'll go through the basics. So what I'm doing is just increasing the exposure so that we can see the foreground a little bit more, and then decreasing the highlights to see the sky and the background, and then increasing the shadow so that the subject pops. Yeah, my sister. And then I'm gonna also increase the white and the black to enhance the contrast, I guess, of the colors. And then we're gonna go to the radio filter. This is very useful because anything, you can click invert right there, and then anything inside the circle you can edit, and anything outside the circle will be untouched. So yeah, very useful. I'm just gonna drop the highlight of the sky so that we can later on increase the exposure of the whole photos and you can still see the sky. You will see later. Right here, there we go. So after that, what I'm gonna do is just to create a radio filter onto the subject, and I'm gonna do the same. I'm gonna put it invert so that it is inside the circle, and I'm gonna increase the exposure and the shadows so that the subject pops from the background. As you can see right here, this just creates like a separation between the background and the foreground and the subject. And after that, I am just going to drop the clarity and then increase the dehaze, drop the vibrance and the saturation, increase the saturation. This just makes it feel more alive, I guess. And then we're gonna move on to the HSL. This basically allows you to change color from red to a bit more orange, from yellow to green, as you can see here. It changes the yellow to the green. So for this part, the HSL slider, you can basically do whatever you want with it. It just depends on how you like your photos. So just make it your own, you know. I will show you once I'm done with the photos. So basically what I did was to increase the orange, because the beanie was orange, and then the background has a huge chunk of orange color in it. And also I increased the luminance for the blue, because the floor was looking a little bit blue. And by decreasing the saturation and increasing the brightness, you basically make the colors go away. So that's a great tip to remember as well. So now we'll move on to split toning. So as you hold down Alt or Option on your keyboard and you drag the hue of the highlights and the shadows, you can see it change. That basically adds color to your shadow and your highlights, and you can increase your saturation to both, to however you like it. Basically, this is the part where you just improvise. It's how you like your photos, so make it your own, I guess. And once we're done with that, I don't really know what calibration does, but I do it sometimes. If I want to make a teal and orange, I just increase the hue of the red and then decrease the hue of the blue and stuff like that, as you can see. And after that, I basically just adjust the color again, just so that it looks right for me and that it doesn't look too weird. As you can see on the ground, it was a little bit too weird, so I adjusted it, the blue, basically, as I said before. And yeah, now we will go on to tone curve, and I'm just basically plotting 3 points. I think one is highlight, one is shadow, and then the other one is mid. And I'm just gonna pull the blacks, I think, and then as you can see, it just creates like a dream-ish kind of feel. And then basically you adjust your highlight and your shadows and your mid to look however you like. Just spend some time on this as you editing, because I think this is what makes most of the pictures looks good, I think. I don't know, but yeah. And now I'm just basically using the brush tool to basically paint the areas that I want to adjust, like those around my sister's face. It's a little bit too bright for me, so I will just reduce. As you can see, I reduced too much, so I'm gonna adjust back to however much I like it, so that it just don't make it look weird, you know. So now what I'm gonna do is to again do a gradual filter on the behind the beanie, just so that the whole beanie looks the same and not under different exposure. This is just a personal thing. You can leave it if you want. Like, if you like the photos, then you can just leave it. But I just do it because I don't want it to look in the different shades. So what I'm doing here now is just to adjust the composition of the photos. You don't have to do it if you like the photos, but you can tweak it a little bit just to see how you like. Maybe move the subject to fill the 2/3 of the photo or 1/3, and just whatever you feel best for yourself. And yeah, I hope you learned something from this, and hope you enjoy it. This is my first time, so I'm sorry if, you know, anything is not perfect or not detailed enough. Please let me know as well. Thank you. See you next time.